Is the Mona Lisa really smiling? Why is it that when you look directly at her, she seems serious, but the moment you glance away, she appears to flash a ghostly smile? Could the painting actually have a soul, giving you that fleeting smile when you're not looking? In 2019, to mark the 500th anniversary of Leonardo da Vinci's death, an international team of researchers used advanced optical technology to study the Mona Lisa, and they might have unlocked some of its mysteries. First, the experts showed an infrared image of the painting, revealing details that have faded over time. For instance, while many of us picture the Mona Lisa as a fuller-figured woman, the infrared scan showed that she was actually draped in a thin, delicate veil over her shoulders, rather than having the fuller appearance we often assume. This hidden detail shows a softer, more graceful image than we expect. They also presented a UV image, which revealed purple spots scattered across the surface. These spots, they explained, were marks left from restoration work done over the centuries. The Mona Lisa was painted on a wooden panel with layers of paint, at least 30 layers thick. The base layer was reflective white, with colors carefully layered on top. Da Vinci treated his paints in a unique way, making them more translucent than modern paints. This layering technique is part of what gives the painting its mysterious depth and sense of life. However, the question of her elusive smile remains unsolved. The research continues. The experts then used x-rays to examine the painting, and soon, something even more astonishing appeared. For example, when experts used x-rays on the works of other artists, they typically found well-defined boundaries in the paintings, where the layers of paint clearly outlined the shapes and forms. However, when they turned the x-rays on Da Vinci's works, they were astonished to find that these sharp boundaries seemingly disappeared. They tested several of his paintings, and the same result kept appearing. When they examined the Mona Lisa, the same phenomenon occurred. The experts exclaimed that Da Vinci's paintings were like phantoms. They disappeared in the x-ray world. At this point, the experts seemed to have found the key to solving the mystery of the smile. They called it the phantom technique, also known as sfumato. Da Vinci was a master of this technique, and in the x-rays, there were no visible outlines. The experts believe this means that, without exception, Da Vinci used this technique for all of the 30-plus layers of paint to create an illusion. As a result, when we look closely at Mona Lisa's eyes and lips, we find that there are no clear boundaries or lines, only a soft blend of light and shadow. Next, an expert had appeared who would help unravel the final mystery, Dr. Margaret, a neurophysiologist specializing in our visual perception system. She explained that in the center of our retina, there are special photoreceptor cells that are almost non-existent in other animals. These cells enable us to perceive sharpness and clarity. The distribution of these cells across the retina is uneven. They are denser in the center and sparser towards the edges, which we commonly refer to as peripheral vision. This means that when we fixate on a single point, we actually miss out on the details in our peripheral vision. To illustrate this concept, Dr. Margaret conducted an experiment. She asked a student to focus intently on a yellow dot located at the tip of the Mona Lisa's nose. After a few seconds, she instructed him to close his eyes. Meanwhile, Dr. Margaret arranged various artworks in his peripheral vision, including both the original Mona Lisa and parody versions. Once everything was set up, she asked the student to open his eyes and glance at the yellow dot for just a moment before closing his eyes again. This exercise required the student to identify the artworks using only his peripheral vision. After dozens of tests, the student only correctly identified the original about 25% of the time. Many of the exaggerated parodies were mistaken for the real deal by his peripheral vision. Dr. Margaret pointed out that this illustrates the true nature of our peripheral vision. It's quite unreliable. But why don't we perceive this unreliability in our daily lives? She explained that our eyeballs are constantly in motion, moving at least 3 times per second. This constant movement helps us gather details about the world around us. Dr. Margaret believes this principle plays a significant role. For instance, after simulating our peripheral vision on a computer, she demonstrated on the screen that the Mona Lisa does appear to be smiling, with the corners of her mouth turned up near her ears, resembling the eerie smile of the slit-mouthed woman. However, when we shift our gaze back to the painting, we realize that the corners of her mouth aren't raised, and she doesn't seem to be smiling at all. Yet as soon as we look away and let our peripheral vision take over, that smile suddenly reappears, allowing us to see her in a different light. But the moment we refocus, the smile vanishes again. This mystery is truly captivating because the Mona Lisa becomes, in our imagination, a smiling, slit-mouthed woman. This is the genius of Leonardo da Vinci. More than 500 years ago, he somehow mastered neurophysiological principles that we are still studying today and skillfully applied them to his artwork. How did he know to use over 30 layers of shading to capture that elusive smile with such precision? Only Da Vinci himself could answer that. Some physiologists have also been involved in solving the mystery of the Mona Lisa smile and have provided another perspective. They discovered numerous anatomical illustrations in Da Vinci's notebooks. Experts estimate that Da Vinci dissected at least 30 human bodies. By comparing his earlier works to later pieces like the Mona Lisa, we can see a clear progression. The faces in his paintings became fuller and more lifelike. Experts believe this is a direct result of Da Vinci's deepening understanding of human anatomy through his dissections. Digging deeper into his notes, they found a section entirely focused on the anatomy of the lips, filled with meticulous details. Eventually, they discovered a peculiar curve that seemed to represent the ideal shape of lips, and astonishingly, it perfectly matched the contours of the Mona Lisa's smile.